Welcome to this tutorial about GRAMM GRAL, a free software package including GRAMM, a prognostic mesoscale wind field model, GRAL, a Lagrangian dispersion model, and a graphical user interface. Hello, my name is Markus and I'll show you how to compute the dispersion of a line source between buildings. I'll use the Linux version today. The usage of the Linux and the Windows versions are almost the same. In Linux, I start the graphical user interface from the terminal using mono and the application's file name. I copied the project from episode 1 to this computer and I load this project here. If we change to the tab GRAL settings, we see that we can't change anything because the project is locked. We see the red lock in the right edge. Now we have to change to the computation tab to delete the GRAL intermediate files. If we delete these files, the project is unlocked, but the evaluated result maps are still available. Now it's possible to modify the project and we change to the GRAL settings tab. If you use buildings, you should use the prognostic GRAL approach. The horizontal and the flow field grid size is set to 4 meters. The flow field grid size defines the resolution of buildings and, if used, of topography. The number of maximum iterations has an influence to the accuracy of the flow field computation. For usual dispersion computations, a value of 500 is okay. If you are interested in detailed flow field analysis, you should set this value up to 2000. Now I can open the GIS window. Because of the different paths between Linux and Windows, I have to define the new position of the background image here. As we can see, the opacity of the background image is low and therefore I adjust or I increase the opacity in the layout manager. Here's still the point source from episode 1 of this tutorial and I delete the point source in this dialog. The next step, I define the GRAL grid. There are some graphical problems in the Linux version and because I like to see the GRAL grid, I go to the object manager and layout manager and switch on the GRAL grid for the GRAL domain area. Now I open the building dialog, define a name for this building and the height of this building, and using the left mouse I define the edge points of the building, and at the end I use the right mouse to save the building. Using the plus I define the next building and use the left mouse, and oops, I use the right mouse now. I don't like that, so I delete this building and add building again. Left mouse, left, 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 and right mouse to define that building. And we'd like to define a third building. And finish the input with the right mouse. I'd like to change edge point, so I click to the number of vertices and see a little red point. Change the coordinate and now I should see the new position and say OK. And I changed this edge point here. Because I can't see the buildings, I open the layout manager for buildings and fill the buildings and set the transparency to a value, and now I see the buildings filled. Now I add a line source. The name is street. You have to set the name. The vertical extensions is set to 4 meters, the width to 6 meters, and then an NOx emission rate of 0.45 kilogram per kilometer an hour. Now I define the edge points with the left mouse, and with the right mouse I define the position, press save source group, and the line source is saved. So it's still possible to change the GRAL domain size, and I'd like to increase the domain size a little bit, and I can close the GIS window. I change the sources tab, define the sources, and I change to the metrological tab, load the meteor file. It's the meteor file from episode 2 of this tutorial. There are eastern and western winds only. At the computation tab, I generate the input files by hitting these buttons and start the computation core. I select the core and the computation starts. This machine isn't too strong, so I have to wait a while, and therefore I cut the video in a few seconds because it's not possible to wait as long here. And if this first situation is finished, it's possible to evaluate the results. I use a result prefix here because I don't like to overwrite the results from episode 1. Then I can change to the domain tab, and well, here it's possible to load the rasterized building file called building-heist.txt. It's localized in the computation folder. Here we see the rasterized buildings and the source. It's also possible, or in the first step, I switch off the GRAL raster because I don't need it anymore, and then it's possible to load the first results from the first situation. In the next step, we can change the view of this contour lines, set the contour lines value and show labels. Well, then we have to wait until the computation is finished. As we see, we are now at weather situation 24, and I cut the video again, otherwise it's boring if we have to wait for such a long time. And well, the situation is finished now. I press the key and I can close the terminal window. In the next step, I do the evaluation of the results again. I use still the prefix street and go to the domain tab, to the GIS window again, and the results are actualized and they are refreshed. As we see, we've got an initial wind field with eastern and western wind directions only, but there is a dispersion in northern and southern direction too. That's because of the prognostic wind fields between these buildings. We will analyze the wind fields in the next episode of this tutorial. Then we can adjust the view of the layout of our contour lines. It's possible to fill the contour lines if you like to. Just click to fill. We use a transparency here, and now we have to click to close a second times, and well, now we see the lines are filled. Well, I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Until next time, bye.